to my s'mores. I am Shannon Morse. Welcome to my channel all about travel and technology. Today, I wanted to give you a quick update on my PC build. There were a lot of questions in the previous video that I did, so I wanted to answer those and also give you some additional footage that I got of some changes that I made and some modifications after the video that I had previously shot. Also, I'm really happy that y'all enjoyed having my husband on the video with me. If you think that I should have him in future videos, let me know. He's not really big in social media or anything like that, but he is a gamer, so he's very familiar with that and he does play a lot of games. Maybe we could do some Twitch streams together? I don't know. So let me know if that's something that you would be interested in. Also, a really quick shout out to Patrick, Nathan, and Randy, who all joined my Patreon. They are my golden and toasted s'mores on Patreon. So if you subscribe on those perk levels, then you get a shout out on the show. So thank you so much to y'all and be expecting a lot more to come. My Patreon link, by the way, is down in the show notes. That includes things like free digital photography downloads of all of my travels, which you can print or do pretty much whatever you want to non-commercially. And I also started up shannonrmorse.com, which is where you can purchase my digital photography if you don't want to do reoccurring donations on Patreon. Totally understand. Some people want travel photography and there it is for you. Okay, so let's go ahead and get to those updates. So again, I did want to mention that most of the products for that build video were sent to me by Asus. I also got the GPU from NVIDIA GeForce, and I got some products from Kingston, and I got the AMD Ryzen 2700X from AMD, which was through Asus. So thank you so much to those companies for sponsoring that video with products. Really appreciate it. And it's still running really great, so yay. So one of the biggest questions I got was, since I was doing this build video at the early June, end of June, whatever that time frame was, a lot of people were just like, why are you building it with the 2700X instead of the third generation, which got announced 2 weeks after my build video? Because they were sent to me. I actually started working on this build video way back during CES. I was networking and getting information out there and trying to see if I could do this collaborative build video with these companies. So it did take some time to get all the products in so that I could actually do the build. So that's why it is a previous generation. But with that said, I am perfectly happy having a previous generation CPU, most notably because the differences, if you look at benchmarks, they're between 10 to 15% increases. And of course you do save a lot of power, between 65 watts with the new 3700X compared to the 105 watts, I believe, on the 2700X. If you have no clue what I'm talking about or you don't care, that's totally fine. I don't do benchmarks on this show, but for what it's worth, I'm totally fine with having a previous generation. And it's not your build. It was my build from the beginning. It's something that I'm gonna be using every single day. So if I'm happy with it, that is exactly the kind of outcome that I wanted. Okay, so in this video, you can see here that I did switch the power supply around. This was actually recorded right after I did the build video because I noticed that I had it backwards. So I did switch it around. I didn't mention it in the previous video because I had already stopped recording, but that's just a little note that I had there that I wanted to include so y'all know that yes, I did switch it around so that the fan is located in the back where it should be. I also, right above the PSU, I removed that hard disk drive enclosure. So this big metal enclosure is found inside of that Corsair case on the back, and it does cover up the back part of the motherboard, which can be pretty safe. However, since I don't have a lot of cabling and I was able to maneuver my cables all to be to the side of it, that just opens it up for a little bit more airflow. So I did remove that since I don't have any hard disk drives in this build at all. Now, speaking of drives, of storage, I did add one other Samsung 1 terabyte solid state drive for all of my video storage. This one actually came out of my previous build, so I did have to, you know, uninstall everything and take that one apart before I was able to install it. So that's just something that I added afterwards. So now I have 3 solid states and 2 NVMEs because I'm crazy. I also exchanged the Kingston 16 gigs of RAM out for Corsair Vengeance RAM. This is 32 gigs. This actually came out of my husband's computer, but he had ordered 4 sticks of RAM, and that's just too many. You don't need 64 gigs of RAM in a normal gaming machine. So I was like, can I have half of that because you don't need it? And he didn't see any difference. He actually took my old 1080 GPU, so he's doing dual GPUs, SLI'd, and he doesn't see any difference with his currently 32 gigs of RAM compared to the 64 gigs of RAM that he previously had. So when you have that much RAM at 32 gigs, you really don't notice a difference, even if you do dual GPUs. I also saw everybody's comments about the thermal strip. I am well aware that I had to switch it out because I threw that one away stupidly. But hey, for my own regards, that was the first time I have ever built a computer that included an NVMe slot whatsoever. So I didn't know what that was. So I do appreciate everybody who was respectful in the comments when they mentioned that I had thrown away something important. I did end up buying a couple. In fact, I have an extra now, which is super cool, off Amazon. They are so cheap on Amazon, and with Prime shipping, it's free. So I was able to get a new one, just installed it in place, and now it's running super cool, which is great. I also added the Republic of Gamers LED strip, which does sync everything up with the Asus Aura software. So it looks really, really pretty. I decided to go with a default rainbow effect because that is my favorite. My cat is meowing in the background. I apologize. I cleaned up the cables in the front so they look a little bit more organized. I know I could do a lot better for like the cable aficionados out there, but guess what? It's not your build. I also did some little stuff, like I updated the firmware in the BIOS, I updated the firmware for, you know, the CPU and the RAM and stuff like that, updated the drivers for the GPU, all the little things that you have to do anytime you do a new build. I also fiddled a little bit with the ROG software that's available for fans on the motherboard. So I did this because I really wanted a quiet computer, and if you listen to any of my guest hosting on like Daily Tech News Show in the past month, you'll notice that you don't hear my fans running in the background at all, which is wonderful because it is sitting directly next to my microphone for my podcast. So I can honestly say this thing is running so freaking quiet that nobody can hear it whenever I'm guest hosting. That's great because that is exactly what I needed as a creative content person. Now the fans do increase whenever I'm playing a game. For example, I've been playing Shadow the Tomb Raider with ray tracing turned on and RTX enabled and DLSS support, and oh my god, it looks amazing. You can absolutely see a difference in the shadow effects whenever you turn off ray tracing and then you turn it on. I can honestly say that. It looks incredible, and it's running at really, really high FPS for ray tracing, like 60 FPS. That's awesome. So yeah, the fans do increase. Whenever I open up Adobe Premiere Pro and go through a whole bunch of like encoding, of course they are going to increase when I do that, or some renders. So that is going to happen. That's pretty obvious. But again, those aren't things that I'm going to be doing when I'm podcasting, so I'm not too worried about that. Now I noticed that my CPU is running around 45 Celsius, which is perfect. That is within the frame that you really want to keep your CPU in. So I'm super happy with that. And then whenever I'm doing that heavy processing, it usually runs around 57 or 58 degrees Celsius, which is high, but that's also expected whenever you're doing something so powerful. So I think that's it for my build video. I'm pretty sure I've mentioned everything. If I didn't, Editor Snubs will add it in for you. But I hope that you enjoyed the build video. I hope you enjoyed seeing all the pictures that I've been posting online, and I hope that you love all the video that I was able to capture from this thing. It honestly has really helped me increase my productivity every single day, because working on just a laptop alone, even if it's a laptop that can edit, it's still a very small form factor, and that makes it really tough to do my job. When I have something that's really big, really powerful, and can run like multiple timelines in Premiere Pro and like a game in the background, or can do like multiple different encodings while I'm editing on a timeline, like there's a bunch of different things that have to do with multitasking. And when it comes to a desktop, it's really like, that's the thing. That's where you really have to do it. And ray tracing is just, it's so sexy. So let me know if you have any other questions about the build video that I did, and thank you so much again to my patrons for supporting my content, and of course be expecting a lot of updates over on Patreon as well as this YouTube channel. Again, thank you so much to my s'mores. I am Shannon Morris, and I will see you on the next video. Bye!